Today we're going to talk about non-dimensionalizing the basic differential equations. In other words, how did we get from this top thing here, to this on the bottom? And if you go through these, all of these are non-dimensional, and the only thing that's in front of our non-dimensional variables are these dimensionless parameters. Here it's 1 over the Reynolds number. Here it's 1 over the Froude number squared. So it's very important when you're non-dimensionalizing differential equations that you go beyond just the variables. You have to collect everything else in a parameter that is also non-dimensional. Otherwise, it won't be non-dimensional. The first thing that we need to do is define our non-dimensional variables. We choose a reference variable and then take our variable and divide it by it. So here we're going to take this as V0 or V free stream. So our U star is U over V free stream. We do the same, and we can use the same reference for both U and V. We do it for X, so that's X over L, as well as Y star, which is Y over L. Some of the things, though, that you have to be careful of are things like T or P, because those you can do it in terms of like a tau or a P0, but in order to really get your dimensionless parameters together, need to put it in terms of other variables. So for example, if we wanted a dimensionless time, we would divide T by L over V. So here we're going to define our P star, or our dimensionless pressure, as P divided by rho V free stream squared. And again, this is a type of pressure term. We've seen it before. And as you'll see, this allows you to non-dimensionalize your equations in terms of variables or things that will be in our dimensionless parameters. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this top one and show you how to go through every single one of these variables and then divide through so that we're able to have only dimensionless variables. So we'll start with obviously we're not going to do anything with rho right now, but we'll start with U. And if you look up above, we can define U, or just rewrite it as U star over V infinity. Now let's look at du dx. Well, this is the same as du star V infinity. We've replaced our U there. And then we've replaced dx with 1 over dx star over dx. And if you notice, that's the same thing as dx star over dx star is just 1. So it's sort of multiplying it by 1. So here we pull out the V infinity, and then all we have is du star dx star. So that's the first term there. How about dx star dx? Well, let's go back to our definition of x star. And if we differentiate x star with respect to x, what do we get? 1 over L. So du dx can be written in terms of du star dx star by putting V infinity divided by L. And we do the exact same thing for dv dy. And because we're using the same references, what you'll see is this comes out to be the exact same dv star dy. Also, when we want to look at v, we go up to our definition of what v star is, and we know that v can just be rewritten as v star times v infinity. Okay, now let's do dpdx, since that's a little bit different. So we start with dp dx, and again, like we did before, it's dp star rho v infinity squared over dx star dx. And now we know what that is, so we just pull out our reference variable. So that's rho v infinity squared over L. Where'd we get that L? Again, that's from dx star dx, like we did before, dp star dx star. All right. Now, let's do the second derivative, the terms that we find on the right-hand side of the equation. And in fact, let's go to another page to be able to do this. And so what we're looking for is d squared u dx squared. So d squared u dx squared is the same as d dx of du dx. Well, we've already defined du dx in terms of dimensionless variables. So that's d dx of that v infinity over L du star dx star. So now what do we do with our d dx? Well, we do exactly what we did before. It's d dx star dx star dx of v infinity over L du star dx star. So that becomes, remember, this dx star dx is 1 over L. So this becomes v free stream over L squared d squared u star dx squared star. And so, as you might have suspected, if you think about what a derivative is, each time we take a derivative, it's what we're taking the derivative with respect to that increases. And that's why du dx had a 1 over L, d squared u dx squared has a 1 over L squared. And so when we put that together, and we do the same thing for the other second derivative, what we're left with is this, that rho u star v infinity, that was our u, v infinity over L du star dx star, so that was our du dx, plus v star v infinity over L dv star dy star. Okay, so that's the right hand side. Now let's look at the left hand side. And that equals minus rho v infinity squared over L dp star dx star plus mu v infinity over L squared. And that's what came out of those second derivatives, d squared u star dx star square plus d squared v star dy star square. And now we're almost done. However, our variables might be dimensionless. But the actual equation is not, because you can see by looking at it that there are still some dimensions. There are the dimensions with rho and mu and everything like that. So we divide everything through by rho v squared over L. All right? So our left-hand side becomes u star du star dx star plus v star dv star dy star. And our right-hand side becomes minus dp star dx star plus mu rho v infinity over L times d squared u star dx squared star plus d squared v star dy star squared. Now we're dimensionless, and what we see here is one parameter, which is 1 over the Reynolds number. So I hope this helps you to figure out how to non-dimensionalize any equation that you'll be given.